Hello everyone, what's up? Welcome to another quick edit video, this time with a blue hour long exposure shot. I was hoping for some reds in the clouds during sunset, but sadly that didn't happen, so let's see what we can do here. As you can see, I'm inside Lightroom Classic and I tried to not use Photoshop for this video. Right away I want to introduce some more base saturation by changing the profile to Adobe Landscape, and then let's work on the colors a little bit. I want this image to be warmer, so let's just boost the white balance temperature. That looks better. Still, there is a little bit of a green color cast, so I'm changing the tint. Okay, nice. Now the exposure does look quite good. Still, I want to bring down the highlights, just so we have more details in those clouds. Then let's increase the shadows a bit. And I want to increase the whites. And for some more contrast, let's drop the blacks. Okay, nice. I do want this image to be sharp, so let's add a little bit of texture. And at the same time, I want to have a dreamy look, so I'm going to reduce the clarity a bit. Okay, and of course I also want this image to be saturated, so let's boost the vibrance. Just like that. That's pretty much it for the base adjustments. Now let's apply some local adjustments. As usual, I'm starting with the gradiated filters. You can see I just have applied one, which covers the whole sky. And I want to start by dropping the exposure, making the top part of the sky darker. Also, I want to have more structure in those clouds, so I'm increasing the clarity. And to not have too much noise in there, I'm dropping the texture, since we don't need any sharpness in here anyway. We could erase a part of this adjustment layer around the tree, therefore I'm selecting the brush, scroll down, and here I'm hitting on this eraser button. And then just brush over this tree, and that should be good. Alright, that's it for the gradiated filters. I also have applied one radial filter, which basically covers the whole center part, and that's because I want to slightly brighten this area up. So yeah, let's increase the whites. Alright, nice, that's it for the local adjustments. Now looking at the histogram, we can see we can push the exposure a little more without risking any overexposure. So let's turn up the whites. Okay, that looks awesome. Then let's continue with the color grading in the HSL tab. I'm going to change the saturation a bit. I guess you can see the green tones are way too saturated. So let's drop the yellow tones and the green tones. Also, I think we can boost the blue tones a little bit. That looks pretty cool. Then for the split toning, I want to go with a cold color tone for the shadows, but of course with way less saturation. Alright, and finally let's sharpen this image. Okay, and maybe we could even add a little bit of vignetting, just like that. Now that's basically it for those raw adjustments. As you can see, there are quite a few sensor spots, which I'm going to remove using the spot removal. And I'm also going to visualize the spots just so I can spot them better. And then I'm just painting over them. All right. That looks nice and clean. While I don't want to use Photoshop, I still want to use the Nick Collection plugin for some final effects. So let's right click, edit in, and here we're choosing Color Effects Pro 4. First off, let's see what the polarization filter does to this image. Oh, I think that looks pretty cool with the dark sky. So let's go with something like this, I guess. And then let's add another filter. Then let's go with the Pro Contrast filter. Here I want to add a little bit more contrast. Okay. And then let's see what we can do for the dreamy look. Let's check the classical soft focus first. I think that might be a little too heavy, so let's choose Glamour Glow. And I guess that's a little heavy as well, so I might not use any dreamy look at all for this image. I think those two are quite good already. So one more thing I want to try. Let's add another filter. Let's apply the foliage filter, which will boost the colors of the grass, especially. I think this looks pretty cool. So let's apply it like this. And here we have the finished image. So this was a super short, quick edit video. I hope it was still helpful and interesting. If you have questions about the editing left, feel free to ask in the comments. I will try to help as always. And thank you very much for watching this video.